Suppose you need to solve an NP-hard problem. What should you do? What can you do? Theory tells us that you're very unlikely to find a polynomial time algorithm. In fact, if you did find one, you would become famous and could probably retire. So far, when we're saying we want to solve something efficiently, what we really mean is the following three things. We want to solve the problem in polynomial time, which means efficiently. We want to solve arbitrary instances of the problem, meaning whatever input you get, we want to find a solution. And third, we want to solve the problem to optimality. We always want to find the best possible solution for the optimization problem. We know that achieving all three of these is probably impossible. So we need to sacrifice some of these three things. Maybe you don't always need to solve the problem in polynomial time. Maybe you know that it's enough to have something reasonably fast for some of the inputs, the ones you are most likely to see in real life. Maybe you know your inputs are quite small and so a really efficient algorithm isn't necessary. Maybe you're just rich and have a lot of computational power and so you don't care about efficiency at all. Although I suspect that's rather unlikely. You might also not have to solve arbitrary instances of the problem. It's possible that you defined your problem in a too general way and you didn't really use everything you know about the instances you will encounter in the real world. Maybe the instances you encounter in the real world have some extra special properties you can exploit to develop more efficient algorithms for those types of inputs specifically. And also, maybe you don't need to find an optimal solution. Maybe you just need to find a solution that's good enough most of the time. So you could use some type of heuristic that, on practical real-world inputs, produces something that's usually good enough. That is a type of thing I want to talk a bit more about in the following few videos. But rather than just hoping that our solutions are probably good enough some of the time or most of the time, we want real guarantees. Again, we want to have mathematical proofs that our algorithms satisfy certain properties rather than just hoping for the best. To this end, we define the concept of an approximation algorithm. An algorithm is an alpha approximation algorithm if it's guaranteed to run in polynomial time, so it's always efficient. It is guaranteed to solve arbitrary instances of the problem, so it can deal with any input you throw at it. And it is guaranteed to find a solution that is, while not necessarily optimal, within a ratio of alpha of the true optimal solution. So for example, suppose you want to find a maximum independent set in a graph. Now, if you have a two-approximation algorithm for this problem, and if the maximum independent set in the graph has size 100, then the two-approximation algorithm should give you an independent set of size at least 50. Or suppose you want to find a minimum vertex cover, and the optimal minimum vertex cover has size 100. If you have a two-approximation algorithm, it should produce a vertex cover of size at most 200. In general, if you have a maximization problem, like maximum independent set, then an alpha approximation algorithm has to produce a solution with a profit of at least 1 over alpha times the profit of the optimal solution. On the other hand, if you have a minimization problem, like minimum vertex cover, for example, then an alpha approximation algorithm has to produce a solution with a cost of at most alpha times the cost of an optimal solution.